Florida Panthers, a team force-fed to the Miami area over 25 years ago in Gary Bettman's great manifest destiny. So far, things haven't really worked out in South Beach. Besides a few years in the mid-90s, they have been completely irrelevant at best. Once in a while, a desperate gasp for air with big splash moves like trading for the Russian Rocket so he could rot on a team with no depth whatsoever. And then counter with even more desperation moves like acquiring Todd Bertuzzi for a luscious sum that included Roberto Luongo. He lasted all of 7 games with the Panthers before being injured and traded. To no one's surprise, the Panthers had been in the basement for so long that there were indentations forming where they had stayed. However, there was hope for the Panthers. They were back on the upswing in 2016, led by Jonathan Huberdeau, Sasha Barkov, old man Jaromir Jagr, the return of Luongo, and a physical defense. They made the playoffs again with the best regular season they ever had. Things are looking on the up and up with Dale Talon. Gerard Gallant was nominated for the Jack Adams Award. They're heavy favorites against the Islanders. They should kick their they got punched by them and jobbed by the refs in Game 6. Welcome back to relevance? But Panthers ownership is dissatisfied with their current direction. They did very well and were victims of playoff puck luck and shitty officiating. There's only one logical option: scorched earth policy. First up, Dale Talon. He's an old fossil whose ideas are outdated and inept. I mean, this guy forgot to tender contracts to his restricted free agents in Chicago 1 year. Do we really want that heading the team? Nope. It's time to fire him via promotion, a dubious punishment for a guy who was bringing our team in the right direction. Look at these fucking Penguins. They won with speed. They won with skill. They won without physicality. This is what they need to emulate. Analytics are the future. The Panthers need to be ahead of the curve. Look at Moneyball. It was goddamn revolutionary for its time, and now it is revered. Don't give me that they didn't win a championship spiel. Shut up. Tom Rowe is the man that will lead them there. The scouts are outdated and have been corrupted by intangibles. The Panthers may have one of the better drafting records in recent years, but they need a new voice in scouting. They need more yes men that nod in approval at their genius. Their scouting director is not one of these men. He shall go to the gallows. This defense is old and lumbering. Those fucking Penguins won a cup with a glut of mobile two-way players. They were good, but not good enough. Gut it to oblivion. Eric Goodbranson has terrible Corsi ratings and is demanding too much money. Thank God Jim Benning is a dunce. Dmitry Kulikov isn't analytically inclined enough either. Trade his ass to the Sabres. Soupy and Willie Mitchell can fuck off to the glue factory. They have real pieces to pick up. Men that will lead the Panthers to a championship. James Reimer, Keith Yandel, and Jason Demers. Sure, they're overpaid, but great Penguin-style talent like them doesn't come cheap. They even get to look good in our brand new uniforms. Don't say they look like the Ottawa Senators. The nerds believe that they will increase Corsi output tenfold. This season is going to be great. A new sexy defense, a great forward core, and a strong goalie tandem. We just signed analytics darlings Aaron Ekblad and Riley Smith to major extensions as well. All of the stat geeks agree that they should be competing for a cup this year. Nothing can stop the Panthers! Huh. Turns out the year has gone to complete shit so far. They are sputtering out of the gate. They need a scapegoat for this failure. That man is Gerard Gallant. He's a stubborn old fuck. He doesn't believe in any of these fancy maths, and the players like him a little too much. Let's also remember those fucking Penguins. They threw their shitty coach into the fire and turned into a goddamn juggernaut multiple times over. Time to sack him. Immediately after the first game of a long road trip. And force him to depart the stadium via taxi. It may be embarrassing as all hell, but his bombastics probably deserved it. Tom Rowe is the future. Mr. Magoo and his merry band of nerds will lead them to the promised land. Too bad nobody is actually there to see it happen. You see, the owners of the Panthers are, should I say, financially inept. Sadly, they're eons better than the previous ones, whom had run the team into the ground so badly that they were losing over 6 figures per day. Their promotional tactics to get people to Panthers games bordered on desperation. Who knew that people don't want to see a shitty team play, especially in a city like Miami, when there are infinite options to spend the entertainment dollar? It also hurts that they put the arena in fucking Sunrise, an area on the outskirts of the city and a half-hour drive away from downtown on a good day. They may as well have put the stadium in Pripyat. Is it any surprise that the stadium is consistently empty? That and an underachieving squad full of parts that never meshed together will do that. Aaron Ekblad suffered massive regression due to injuries. The depth had disintegrated into sand on South Beach. They were throwing out inferior trash like Paul Thompson and Jakob Kindle because their suckage per 60 and defensive zone pylon ratios were better than the remaining options. To call this season a disaster would be like calling the Titanic hitting an iceberg a minor disturbance. So it turns out the team is hockey's Tenerife and a laughingstock of the NHL once again. The Corsi gods have failed them. What they need to do is go back to the glorious past of 1 year ago. Mr. Magoo is a conniving, power-hungry curmudgeon. Get booted into the Atlantic for the triumphant return of Dale Talon. This team is a confused, incoherent mess that has been led astray by analytics. It's time to take it back from the nerds.
Get those nerds!
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 Jonathan Marchessault was their best scorer and one of the lone bright spots on the team this year. But look at him, he is tiny and a scrub. He's only perfect for Whirlies. The nerds like him too much. Let him get picked up by Vegas in the expansion draft. And you know what? This Riley Smith guy is vastly overpaid and analytics like him too. Vegas will pick up his salary as well. Jussi Jokinen sucks yet again. Buy him out. Old man Jager is too old. Bye-bye. Jason Demers is overpaid and a bad fit on our squad. Let's trade him! You mean nobody wants to trade for him? Shit. You know what they do need? More Russians that those Poindexters hate. Time to sign former Panther Evgeny Dadonov to a large contract. And let's throw in Radim Verbata as well. This assistant GM is a dork and needs to be shoved in a locker. We need to give these losers some wedgies too. We have the answer for that. Bob Buchner and Chris Pronger.
No!
So this was what it was like to clean up after Fukushima. The Panthers are what a meddlesome ownership group that has no idea what the hell it's doing will do to a team. They took a formidable squad and turned it into this. Sure, Florida's future isn't completely fucked. They still have some really nice pieces in their core, but their recent actions have set the team back at least 3 or 4 years. Who knew that by trying to imitate a successful team, you usually get inferior versions of said team. Thus is why the Panthers' sudden shift in focus to analytics was a catastrophic failure. Now they get to cut their budget by $10 million next season. You couldn't expect anything less from a nominee for Secretary of the Army. At least he can try to punch more concession workers in the face. That might help the Panthers win.
And now Santa hit, kicked up by Oppozo. Tavares, pad stop Luongo. Tavares!